After nearly a year of fundraising, everything from school discos to bake sales and even a football training camp for the younger years, and 20 hours of travelling from Amsterdam through Dubai to Nairobi, we finally made it to Njaro, and nothing we'd done over the year could really have prepared us for our arrival, or any of what we were about to experience for that matter. The hospitality was truly genuine and one of the warmest welcomes we could have hoped for.
Jambo, jambo bwana, habari gani, nzuri sana, wageni, wakaribishwa, Kenya yetu, hakuna matata.
It was great to finally get started on the work, but we soon realised that it wasn't as easy as we'd been prepared for, doing things such as breaking the bricks, mixing the cement, and digging the foundations were all incredibly laborious, and we really felt it on our muscles after the first couple of days. But it was really a great experience, and we got to learn new skills, and it was great to see the teamwork within the team as we managed to get the job done and built the two classrooms. And it was also really great to see the students getting involved and helping out with. It was also great to see the little kids moving these rocks, and when we formed long rock lines where we were passing rocks from person to person, it was great to see what teamwork could really do. It was also inspiring to see that these kids were really getting involved in a project that is ultimately theirs as more than ours, as it's their classroom.
Coming here, it was quite surprising how much everyone wanted to say hi, give you a high five, ask you questions. I think it's amazing how the community has come together, especially with the parents fundraising for their own bits of buildings. I think that's incredible how they've done that. And it's really nice to feel like we've been a part of it. But I think definitely, like, us being here, I think we've given people the tools to realise that they actually have the ability to affect change in their own communities, and I think that's much more impactful.
I think school it is important because it enables people to learn more.
Breaking the rocks for the foundations was absolutely exhausting. Some rocks would just not break. But knowing what this classroom meant to the students at Ndege, we found the extra strength needed to complete the task. It was completely worth it.
It's pretty much just taught me, like, how we take a lot of things for granted back in Europe, because we're coming here, a lot of the kids and the students here, they're so enthusiastic about the education and they're so happy and generous to talk about what they want to do, what they want to become, and the way they've just helped us with this project, it's amazing, because I doubt we'd ever see anything like this back home. So it's really just humbled me and taught me gratitude.
What is your favorite subject?
Math. English.
Math.
Science.
English.
Social.
Swa.
English.
Science.
We're making the support beams, which are going to go on top of the building, and the roof to support the roof. Yeah.
Is it easy?
It's pretty simple. It's just a bit tedious, but quite therapeutic actually.
One thing that's definitely struck me is how much I take for granted back home, which sounds, I know, it sounds kind of obvious and kind of cheesy, but when I went to church, the local church, Miss Laher had a talk with the pastor, and he asked him about what he thinks are the biggest problems facing the community. And he said the first two things were roads, like repairing roads and getting clean water. And I just realised that those are two things that I never ever think about as a problem in my life. Like, they're always there for me. I don't think I've ever like struggled to get clean water. So it's just like, they just have to look at life a completely different way. Not even because of like a mindset, just because of their circumstances. So I definitely think I'm going to keep that in mind when I go back home, like what things are luxuries to me compared to what they are to them.
Hi, I'm Vika. Very, very careful. We're going to pass it by. We are adding 4. Let's go to 9. 9, okay, add 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Write the answer.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, white words in the air, answers in the air.
Which one is it?
Which is the longest one? Well done, I see all the right answers.
So we're teaching longitude and latitude, and we could just really see the differences between the classes here and the BSN.
It was great to see the enthusiasm in the children and to realise how thankful they are for just the little things that we do. And I think it's really helped me appreciate my education and show like what we have is, you know, we're very thankful for what we have as well.
Library, Ndege Library is very important to the pupils in this school because it has given them a place to come and relax. Some of them don't like to go and play outside. They come here, take a book, read a book on anything. The BSN has brought us so many books of different topics and titles. When children come here, they pick those books about beetles, about lions, about elephants, about crocodiles. And these children have only heard of those animals, but they have not seen. So in these colored pictures, they have really enjoyed. That's why they like coming here.
The library is important because it helps the reader to how to make sentences and to sweeten your English.
Okay, at the moment it is break time. Why do you prefer to be in the library than outside?
I prefer being in the library because when I'm outside I don't learn things, but when I'm in the library I learn many things.
Thank you.
I like to be in the library because when I go in the class, my mind will be fresh and I will be able to learn so faster.
When I am in the library, I like so much because it helps me in composition, writing, and class.
When I am in the library, I like coming here because I can improve my studies, and in my leisure time, I can come and read something new and I can write it in my composition.
When I am in library, I learn more about the life skills and so many other things because when I am in class, I study well, but not well than here.
I like being in the library so that I cannot be idle outside. But yeah, just I have
created my own timetable so that sometimes I'm in the library, sometimes I'm in the field, because work without play makes Jack a dull boy.
Finally seeing the completion of the primary school building's foundation and walls was extremely satisfying to see. This seemed to be our first real big contribution to the school, and we were all surprised by how quickly it had come into being. The next week we moved on to start with the foundations of the secondary school building. It felt like a daunting prospect to start the whole process again, but this time we felt like we knew what we were doing. The relationship we had with the secondary students was also very different to the primary children. We had the opportunity to have more in-depth, heartfelt conversations with the older students and found many things to talk about that we had in common, like music, favourite subjects, life after school and so forth.
My name is Sam. I love business and I wish to do accounts.
I think school is important because it helps us to learn. Life, it comes easier if you go to school.
A lunchtime club for 13 children, all with undiagnosed learning difficulties. By creating an individual group session with only these kids, they were giving time away from school life just to play and be creative. Thanks to Matthew Stower's donation, we were able to provide the department with a year's supply of nappies and gloves, and were also able to build 6 wheelchair ramps.
So around this area there is quite a bit of problems with hookworms and other worms that have entered the children's bodies, and therefore as one part of the project we decided to help these students by providing them with worming tablets.
With the help of the health officers and the head teacher Elizabeth, we headed to a pharmacy and negotiated a price for 2,000 worming tablets for the children and then proceeded to distribute them.
We learned that the medical attention that they have is quite minimal, and that whatever we can do to help them have healthy lives is very much appreciated by the whole community.
The breakfast program, funded by BSN Project Africa, guarantees breakfast for all the primary students every school day. It was incredible to see all the children lining up patiently waiting to be served their mug of nutritious porridge. We've realized that the program had a significant difference in the children's lives. The school attendance increased, the children performed much better, and in general were a lot happier. It was a great feeling to be able to provide this hot meal.
So last year my sister was part of Project Africa, and she had told me about the children here and how they act and how they are so grateful for everything and us all coming here as a team, but it's not realistic until you experience it yourself, and it's just amazing to see how the children are so grateful and appreciative of everything, as when you come here they give you notes, love notes, they give you sweets, they give you anything they can, even though they have the minimum of life, whereas we have all these things at home, and it's just so amazing to see how happy they are with the smallest things in life.
How has it changed you as a person?
I think for myself, I've become a lot more grateful for the small things in life myself, because at home I'd get overwhelmed or stressed about the smallest things that just are not important at all. And it's really, like, it's obvious to see that these kids are like that, and like I want to adapt to that as well.
What are you gonna miss?
I think most of all I'm gonna miss the kids and their enthusiasm for the project. They've been so helpful with what we're doing, and they're so interested in what we're doing, and they appreciate it so much. They're also, their enthusiasm for the education is just amazing.
I'm gonna miss most just the people in general, because there's just so much trust.
I think as well as the friends I've made, I'm going to miss working as a team with everyone and achieving great things. I really like seeing the progress we're making day to day.
I'm just going to miss how happy and generous everyone here is.
It was especially interesting for me to talk to the girls, as I learned so much from them about their lifestyle and the opportunities they have in life. For example, many of them also spent several years working between years of schooling in order to pay for the rest of their own education. For the secondary students, if any of them were to have a boyfriend at the school, they would be expelled. I spoke to so many girls who were intelligent, funny, physically and mentally strong, witty, ambitious and brave. It was so inspiring to hear the plans they had for the future and the commitment they had to their education.
My name is Michael. I'd like to greet you all. I live in Kenya. Our county is Nakuru. I'd like to greet all of you. I'd like to request the next time if you come, to come and help us to build another class. We are saying thank you for everything you have done to us. We have appreciated. I don't know the way we can tell you thank you, but I know God will bless you. That's all.
Thank you for your free interaction with our community. When I talk of a community, I'm talking about the school managing committee. I'm talking about the office. I'm talking about the teaching staff. I'm talking about the people who are very grateful about your interaction, your free interaction with them. They learn a lot. If you happen maybe to have a walk across the village, you'll see how surprised the other kids in the village will be to see a white man. But our kids here have that privilege that they know you can interact freely, you can teach, you can learn from them, and we thank you for your free interaction.
Thank you, our visitors, for coming here in Kenya. We appreciate you very much. You have constructed us what we have and we didn't have. So we thank you all, and you are welcome again next year.